Hello and welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can pass Excel assessment test. When you come to employment agency, a lot of times they want to validate your Excel skills by giving you a test. They give you a lot of different tests. This is just one of the examples. In this video, we're going to go step by step and complete all 20 steps of this test. What you see on the screen is the practice document on the left, and you see list of steps on the right with the status. So we will go one by one and complete each step of this Excel assessment test. For the best results, I recommend you download the sample file from my website and follow me, so this way you can learn and be successful as part of the test. Let's focus on the step number one. So the step number one asks us to extend column B to fit total cost by month. So column B is this column, and total cost by month is this value. So as part of this step, what we need to do, we need to expand column B so the value of total cost by month fits into the column B. And we'll mark this step as completed. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to change background in the status column to green. To best complete exercises, it often helps to understand what kind of data you're dealing with. So let's closely look at the data. This is the table with business expenses, and looks like expenses categorized by different items. We have office supplies, lease, utilities, phone expense, computer and internet expenses. Then we have values by month. We have January through May, and these are the values related to these expenses. Knowing this information will help us to complete step number two of Excel assessment test. To complete this, let's go ahead and read it. We need to calculate total cost of expenses by month using formula. We already extended the column to fit total cost by month. Now we need to populate the values here in the row 12. The best formula to do this work is the sum formula. You can type in sum formula. I'll show you multiple ways how you can do it. You can type formula, sum, and then you just highlight the range for which it's applicable, and then you close the parenthesis and hit enter. So this is the total value. Another way to do it is there is a sum formula button. So you click it, and Excel anticipates very correctly, or often correctly, in this case definitely correctly, what the range is. So I'll hit enter again. And the third way would be when you already have the formula, you can just extend it. You see this, I selected the formula value, and value shows right here in the formula box. We can extend it, and I'll just extend it till the end of the first quarter. And first quarter is January, February, March. And another way to do it would be copy and paste values. So you can copy value, and copy is through this copy button. And then we highlight the area for March through May, and then we click the paste button. So now we've populated total cost by month in the row 12, and we can mark this step as complete. Let's go and continue to the step number three, and step number three is create border around the table. So first we need to understand what is the table, and in this case table is all expenses, even the ones that we have not calculated yet, with the total cost and then average cost, which we have steps to calculate later. So what we need to do, we need to highlight the table, select borders around the table, and the best value for this selection is all borders. So this is what I'm going to select, and this completes step number three. Let's go to step number four, format data as currency. So what we need to understand here is the difference between values for the monthly expenses and total expenses versus just the text values, which describe expenses themselves. What we need to do, we need to format data values as currency. To do that, we need to highlight the data and select the currency sign, accounting number format, It's a dollar sign for me because I'm located in the United States, might be different for your country. And we've completed step number four, so now we can mark it as complete. Now let's go ahead and continue to step number five. And in step number five, we need to use formula to calculate total costs. So formula would be the same. The best way to calculate total costs would be to use the sum formula. And we already looked at how to use it. The only difference would be we used it vertically to calculate values for the column. Now we'll be using it horizontally to calculate values for the rows, but the concept is the same. For sum, it doesn't matter. It uses the range, so I am going to just use the button on the ribbon toolbar, and I put the cursor into the cell I6, click the button, and Excel predicted correctly that the range I'm trying to calculate sum for is C6 through H6. So I'm going to hit enter, and I'm just going to extend the range for this values up to the total cost by month. And you see total cost by month doesn't fit as well as our header, so it's better for us to extend it a little bit. And we can mark step five as completed. As you can see, I have to expand the values, so it doesn't fit anymore, so I'm going to zoom out a little bit so we can continue to see all the values as well as the steps in assessment test. And I use the zoom out bar at the bottom right corner of Excel. Let's go and continue and do step number six. And step number six asks us to use a formula to calculate average costs. For average costs, let's extend the column J a little bit, and I'll show you another way to extend the column so all the text fits. You can just double click on the line, and that separates J and K, and that expands the column up to the size of the text that's in the column J. So what we'll do now, we will use average. And average formula, remember I showed you how to use sum formula, type it in manually. So we can use equal and then say average. And then we have to select the range. And the trick here is that we do not want to include total cost by into calculation of the average. We just need to select the values from C6 through H6, which would represent all the values for office supplies. And then we close the parenthesis. You see the formula here and hit enter. So our average cost for office supplies is $351.15. You can extend this formula because it's going to be the same, all the values up to the internet. There's no reason to calculate average total cost by month. I guess we can, so we'll just extend it. And we'll mark step six as complete. Let's continue to step number seven. And in step number seven, it asks us to change alignment in column D to right. So column D is February month. We can select column D. And there's no alignment right now in column D, but this is the right alignment. And that button, by clicking Align Right, completes the step 7 in our checklist. And we'll mark step 7 as complete. Question number 8. Calculate quarterly costs for Q1 and Q2. So Q1 is January through March, and Q2 is April through June. And the best way for us to calculate total cost for the quarter would be to sum up total cost by month. So we will use two columns, two cells actually. One would be to say that this is Q1 costs, so we're adding new values. Here and here we will calculate the values. It's going to be sum. Sum would be calculated customly by selecting values in the row 12, C12 through E12, and then we'll just hit enter. So this would be Q1 costs. Q2 costs we will report here. Q2 costs in the cell H13. We'll calculate it the same way. Select the sum button, and Q2 would be April through June. $6,823.13 are costs for Q2. And we can mark step 8 as complete. Let's continue to the next step, step number 9. In step number 9, we need to save the file to documents folder. To do that, we click on the file tab, and we click save as, and we click browse, and documents folder be right here. So we select documents folder, and the name of the file, we just check that everything's good, and we click save button. Let's mark step number 9 as complete. Now we can move to step number 10. And step number 10 is change page orientation to landscape. So page orientation is defined in page layout tab. So we click on the page layout tab and we click on orientation. Right now you see orientation is portrait. So we just need to switch orientation to landscape, and we can mark this step as complete. Go back to the home tab and fill the color for this cell. Let's continue and go to step number 11. And in step number 11, we need to fit work table into single page for printout. So first let's define work table. Work table is the table that we're working with, obviously, which does not include the steps for assessment test. To do that, the best way to complete this part would be to select the print area. And to select print area, we need to first see how our document turns out. So in print preview, to do that, we need to click file and then print, and it shows print preview. And you see that it does show our work table, but this might be misleading because there is a second page here, since there is a scroll bar on the right. And if we click scroll bar, we see this table. So ultimately, the objective is to eliminate this table with the steps, and for printout purposes, only have business expenses table select. To do that, let's go back to our work document, and we need to define print area. So we need to select the area that we'll be working with, and I'll expand area a little bit just in case we need to add more values around our work table. And I'll select the range between A1 and K23, and I'll go to page layout, and this is where we define print area, and we select set print area button. So click on the print area button first and then set print area. So now we have print area defined, and let's go and verify our print area by navigating to file tab, print, and as you can see, we now only have one page with our work table ready for printout. This way we can mark step 11 as complete. We go back to the home tab and mark it as complete. Let's go to step number 12. And step number 12, here we need to center table header values. So table header is this row 5. To center all these values, we need to select them and then click the center button, and that completes step number 12. So we can mark it as complete. Let's go to step number 13. And in step number 13, we need to spell check the document. To do spell checking, we can go to review tab, and there is a spelling button. So let's click spelling, and it asks us, do you want to continue checking at the beginning of the sheet? And we say yes. Spell check is complete. Everything looks good. One thing I'd like to show you here, if you don't know where function is located, because it's not obvious where a spell check would be, let's go back to the home tab. What you can do, there is a search box, and you can just type for the function here the one that you're trying to find, and spelling would be one of them. So we click spelling, and it shows actions, and it clicks spelling, and it actually goes through the same set of actions. You can find any Excel function in the search box. I'm gonna click no because we've already done it, and we'll mark this step as complete. Let's go to step number 14, and in step number 14, we need to rename sheet 1 and call it a business expense. So sheet names are at the bottom left. So we have sheet 1 right here. To rename it, you can do it multiple ways. One way is right mouse click and click select rename. There's also option of just double clicking on the sheet name, and you can start typing right away. That's kind of a shortcut. So we need to mark it as business expenses. And you can just click anywhere outside of this title, and rename is complete, and we can mark step 14 as complete. Let's continue, and in step number 15, we need to add a new worksheet. This is easy. There is a plus button which highlights and allows you to add new worksheet. We just click on this, and by default, it's going to take the name sheet 1, but there are no instructions of renaming it or anything, so we'll just go back to business expense and mark this step as complete. Let's continue and go to step number 16, and in step number 16, we need to create a column chart to show expenses for the first quarter. So first quarter values are January through March, and expenses are listed here. So to do that, we need to select the area of expenses, include the types of expenses, and include the values January through March. So it's basically a range between the cells B5 and E12. So once we selected all this area, we need to click insert button and insert chart, and it asks us for column chart, right? And when we click this extension arrow, it shows 2D column or 3D column, so we can, I guess, select any one of those. It does not indicate which one you like. So the fancier looking ones are 3D columns. So if you like, you can select that. I'm gonna just choose the basic one. And now the chart is created. There are no additional instructions. What we need to do here, you certainly can play with this. But what I'm going to do, one important consideration is make sure it fits into the print area. And print area is highlighted. You see it ends at the row 23. So I'm gonna make this chart a little bit smaller by resizing it and move it. I'm gonna move it here into this area so it fits into print area and make it even smaller. So this way it fits into the print range area. And this way we can mark step 16 as complete. Let's go and complete step number 17. And in step 17, we need to change the width of column I and J so the content fits. You see that column I has a total value by month hidden. That's what this pound sign means, that we don't see the whole value. To expand it, we just need to double click on the separator between columns I and J, and that extends the column so all the values fit now, and we can mark this step as complete. Moving on to step number 18, we need to bold all headings and change headings font to 12 points. So first of all, let's define headings. Headings are is a range B5 through J5, so let's select it first. We need to make it bold by clicking the bold button. That's one way. Another way is if you do right mouse click, bold button is available here as well, right on the context sensitive menu. So let's choose it here. And then we will change the font size. Right now it's size font 11 of Calibri font. We'll change it to size 12. And this way we can highlight and mark step 18 as complete. Let's go to step number 19, and in step 19, we need to merge and center the table heading business expenses. So first, let's locate business expenses. Business expenses are in cell B3, and we need to merge and center them. So to do that, we need to merge all the cells between B3 and J3. To do that, we need to highlight them, and we need to click here on the alignment settings and select alignment itself and click merge cells. Click OK. So this merges all the cells. Now it becomes one single cell, and it will behave as one single cell. And we just need to center business expenses here. To do that, we select this cell and click center button, and now business expenses are centered. We can mark step 19 as complete. And let's move on to step number 20, the last step in our exercise. Here we're going to forecast lease cost for third quarter by calculating Q3 total. So it's a little bit tricky question, but let's see how we can address it. Let's find the lease costs. So lease costs, if we look, they are fixed and similar. So January through March, the amounts are the same. Not everything is the same, as you can see. Only lease is the same, and then we have internet costs are the same. But internet costs go same through Q1 and Q2. Lease costs increased from Q1 to Q2. They increased by $20. So, and the exercise asks us to forecast lease costs for third quarter by calculating Q3 total. So we'll make an assumption that because they increased from Q1 by $20 to Q2, we will have the similar increase from Q2 to Q3. And we will make calculations based on this assumption. To do that, let's move this chart a little bit to the right, and we will say lease cost forecast for Q3. Here in this cell, we will calculate the value, and the value would be we'll have 790. We'll take the value from April, let's say. We'll add $20. And we'll put it in parentheses, and we'll multiply by 3. And that gets us to the total of $2,430. And that's estimated forecast for lease cost with the assumption that it's going to increase by $20 per month in Q3. And this allows us to mark step 20 as complete.
If you like the content, please make sure to click the like button and share with your friends. Also, there's tons of information in the description of this video. Make sure to check it out.
Make sure to check out my other relevant videos and subscribe to my YouTube channel. We have a lot of great stuff planned in the pipeline, and I don't want you to miss any of it. And if you'd like to get notified about all the new stuff that are coming out, make sure to subscribe to my email list as well. All links are here on the screen. Make sure to click to stay in touch. Thanks again for watching.